So I'm here in DC. My dad's about to get honored by the Redskins. It's pretty cool, you know, the Redskins are giving the players, the replacement players from 1987 Super Bowl rings. Really exciting day. We're in the hotel right now. We're gearing up, ready to go to Redskins Park and get these guys recognized. Check in with more later.
Get each used car a deal rating, that's what the best deals first. And now, that's a great deal.
Somebody get a promotion
that produces $50,000 a month in cash.
Save 45.
Okay. It's Tuesday, June 12th.
June 12th.
2018. We are in this lovely state of Virginia. Leaving the great folks at the Holiday Inn on our way to Redskin Park to see a one Kieran Bigby get recognized.
In 700 feet, turn left onto Shaw Road.
So, Dad, I'm gonna ask you a few questions on our way to the ceremony.
All right, son.
Just shoot it straight.
Turn left
and keep
onto
my eye on the road.
Yep, and keep your eye on the road. I'm not here, just talking to me.
Okay.
So I'll let you take this turn, and then we're going to get going.
In a quarter mile, turn left onto South Sterling Boulevard.
All right, I'll saw you with a layup. How you doing today?
I'm doing well, man. Feeling refreshed. Nice day out here in Northern Virginia. Pretty excited.
How was the ride in?
Not
turn
too bad.
Turn left onto South Sterling Boulevard,
you know,
then
feels
turn right.
Pretty good to be down here with you, you know, so it's good. It's real good.
All right. Picking up steam a little bit. Washington Redskins, what does that mean to you?
Wow, there's a lot of mixed emotions in that. You know, coming out of the Ivy League at the time when I did, there weren't really a lot of Ivy League players. I mean, Calvin Hill, who played running back for the Cowboys, he had gone to Yale, star standout there. Gentleman by the name of Ed Marinaro from Cornell. And then I had a gentleman that had played before me at Brown, John Woodring, who played linebacker with the Jets, and probably most notably, Steve Jordan, who played tight end with the Minnesota Vikings, had a over 10-year career. So there's very few guys that were out there in general. So, you know, getting the opportunity was, you know, tremendous. And, of course, all the analytics and things that they have today, that wasn't there in my day. But it still was a very good experience to be chosen to attempt to play on a professional level. So the Redskins were my first tryout. And so I got that one out of the way. I will tell you candidly that I didn't think that I had done well because my tryout was all of probably about 10 minutes. I ran 3 40-yard dashes, a vertical jump, caught a down and in, a down and out, and a post, and then they said that was it. So evidently that meant I did very well, but at the time I was like, wow, I must have sucked.
To exit left onto VA 625 West and Maxwell Road toward Ashburn.
I remember calling my dad right afterwards and saying, you know, Dad, I don't think this went really well. He was like, why? I said, because I spent more time getting to Redskin Park than I did actually trying out. You know, rest turned. Mr. Beathard, who's going into the Hall of Fame this year, actually came to me and told me that I was being chosen, and the journey began. So wasn't a Redskin fan. Of course, I was growing up in New York. I was a Giant fan, and I had just watched the Giants the previous year win the Super Bowl. So it was kind of difficult trading those allegiances, and when you say the Redskins and the Giants did not like one another, that was an understatement. But I think there was a lot of respect between the two coaches and also the two teams. So camp was interesting. Had never been through anything really like that, again, on a professional level. And You know, Ivy League camp is far different than probably Big Ten or Big 12 camp. You know, I found myself really being a fan at the same time while I was attempting to make a team, and got the opportunity to get down to be one of the last cuts. I knew it was going to be a difficult journey to begin with. The Redskins were returning four wide receivers. So they were only looking to really select one if they were going to select one. And at that time, you could bring more than 90 people to camp. So at that point, there was 135, 140 people in camp. If I recall correctly, we were double digits in wide receivers. So I guess it made sense for us to be there to help take some of the stress and strain off of guys like Art Monk and Gary Clark and Ricky Sanders. So I was glad to do my part, I guess. But the strike was interesting as well. I mean, I was the baby on the team. I had just pretty much turned 21 when I went into camp. And, you know, seeing all of this go on and really not knowing anything about union, labor unions and union strife and things of that nature. So pretty much how it was depicted in The Replacements with Keanu Reeves was pretty similar to, you know, how things went down. So and then, you know, actually after, you know, we had won three games through the strike, it was now my time to really root for the team to do well, because there was money in it for me in terms of playoff share and Super Bowl share and things of that nature. So very exciting time.
1.1 miles, and, turn right onto Redskin Park Drive.
Very happy to have had that experience.
Now, growing up on the PAL football field as a Central Islip, playing for Grandpa, playing for your dad, did you ever picture yourself getting a Super Bowl ring?
I can't really say I saw that. I can't really even say that I've fast-forwarded to being able to play on the professional level. I just knew that it was a game that my father and I shared a love of, and that he gave me an opportunity at a very early age to be able to play in an organized setting. The sacrifices that he made to put me in it, pay for it, take me to practice, ultimately coach me. Achieving that was, I think, as much an honor to dedicate to my dad as much as it was for me to be actually be able to play.
Where in Michigan?
Can you quit fishing?
Oh, yeah, okay.
How are you? Don't make me get up, man. Don't make me get up.
I appreciate that. Okay. After football, he went to a management position with Home Depot, Target, and his regional director would rent a center right now. You need it, he's got it.
Ha ha.